I want to welcome all of you to the Christ Church here. It's a very beautiful building. I hope you're enjoying the visual sights. We have the angels, who are all musicians apparently. And so we'll all have to be on our guard today. I'd like to thank the Brockton Cable Authority and the for working with the videotape and our Steve Walsh who's doing the recording. And that, of course, thanks to the performers who are lending their time and performing for us today. And thanks for the Christ Congregational Church for this beautiful space and their piano. We begin with the Brandenburg Concerto. The musicians will talk to you about that now.
Okay. Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay, Brandenburg number 5. Written by Johann Sebastian Bach, who probably everybody knows. Should probably take off the mask so you can hear me speak. Bach was born in 1685 and died in 1750 and produced a huge amount of music that is still played today. The Brandenburgs are quite famous now. However, at the time that he wrote them, they apparently sat unplayed for about 100 years. He had written them over a period of time, and in 1721, he presented them as a gift to the Margrave of Brandenburg. I've read various accounts, some of which mentioned that this was probably hoping that he might get employment there, but that didn't happen. And the Margrave was apparently not very musical and put them in the archives, and they weren't picked up until 100 years later. Now it's one of the most well-known of the Bach sets of music. Totally instrumental, unlike a lot of his work. This one, number 5, in D major, right? Yeah, in D major, was written for the instruments that he had at hand at the time, being chamber music, meaning you play it in a small room. He wrote the 6 Brandenburgs with different instrumentation in mind. So it's quite interesting if you look at all of them. Each one requires a different instrumentation. This instrumentation happened to fit our group pretty perfectly. So we've been playing it for a long time. It actually calls for a violin and a flute and a transverse flute, actually, from the beginning. So a lot of pieces, like number 4, which was the first one I played in high school, it called for 2 recorders. But a lot of high school orchestras don't have that, so you can hear it with a flute, 2 flutes, a flute and recorder, whatever you would have. But Bach knew that that's the way they would be played. So we don't know exactly when it was written, but presented in 1721, 301 years ago, in March, to the Margrave. We're going to start with a little bit from the second movement, kind of set the mood, and that's an andante, and then go into the first movement, which is an allegro. The group, we have violin, Chris Nicholas, Thomasine on the flute, Hal J.P. on the piano. And yes, it was originally written for harpsichord, but it is usually now played on the piano. Susan Keddy on cello, and Dane Meadow on viola, and our 2 second violins are Carol Rankin and Bethany. I don't even know your last name. Stephanie. Which we're very lucky to have because she really fills out our orchestral feel. So, enjoy.
Thank you.
that was delightful. I think there can never be too much Bach. While they are rearranging the chairs. While they're rearranging the chairs, I'll just mention that the next piece is by Eric Lundgren. He's a local composer who lives in Minneapolis, Middleborough, and he has been a member of the Symphony Board for years. We're glad to have him. And with him is Thomasine, who's back was with us for the Brandenburg, and she'll be performing with him. So I'll get out of there with
him. Greetings. That was part of the title of this next composition. It's called Greetings from Elizabeth Tower. A lot of blank faces there, huh? Does anyone know what Elizabeth Tower is? Well, I'm going to give you a clue. There's something really big in Elizabeth Tower. Anyone get the clue? Anyone hear of a thing called Big Ben? And Big Ben, when he speaks in a melody. You ever hear that melody? Well, anyway, back around 2016, I was an artist in residence up in Western Canada, in Alberta, at the Banff Center. And this is a project that it occurred to me this would be a great theme to do a theme and variations on. So I was up there for a little over a week and composed this 12-movement suite here. And it's interesting because all the 12 movements, I decided to put them, each one in a different, not necessarily key, but tonal center. A key might imply, you know, classical music like what we just heard here, you know, in the Baroque Bach piece. But these are tonal centers. And there's 12 notes on the piano, and each one of the variations is in a tonal center there. One other thing to listen for in it, Big Ben does clangs, big clangs. You know, it'll have, like, if it's 1 o'clock, you'll hear a clang, one clang. If it's 3 o'clock, you'll hear a clang, clang, clang. So what I did is I incorporated that into every one of the movements, too. So it's kind of a fun listening thing because the melody pops up all sorts of ways. Thomasine will be playing it, I'll be playing it, and you'll hear all these little variations and these snippets. But anyway, we're going to do this, and then afterwards we're going to do two very short pieces by Jacques Hubert. So this is Greetings from Elizabeth Tower. Thank you.
Thank you. variation, a fugue. I'd like to bring back Tennessee Berg. She thought she was done. She's worked overtime. We actually have two very short little pieces right now. This is by French composer Jacques Ibert. He wrote a suite called Histoires, or Histories. And there's two movements there, which we have a flute and piano arrangement for. The first is called A Giddy Girl. And the second one is called The Little White Donkey. Thank you.
Excuse to bring Thomasina back again. Okay, while we're getting the seats together, I just want to mention that our search for a new music director is progressing. We have a slate of candidates, and one of them will be conducting a concert in the near future. In March, it'll be the first time in 2 years that the symphony has been will have a full symphony concert of the Brockton Symphony, and the conductor will be Dr. Don Running, our first guest conductor, chairperson of music at Bridgewater State, and the Brockton Symphony's bass trombonist. He'll present an all-American program featuring Robert Finley performing Gershwin's Rhapsody in Blue. Everybody knows that. And there'll be a black composer, Adolph Hasling, has done something with three spirituals, and of course, and Bernstein's Overture to Candide. So it sounds like quite a concert, and it'll be March 3rd. Album is also going to be a premiere by a local composer, David Voss. So that looks like the chairs are all set up. So I'll just mention that we have another piece. This is a theme and variations from Joseph Blumer. He was a East German composer, born in Dresden, and his dates are 1881 to 1964. This is a theme in six variations. I have heard the first movement. The first movement is very dreamy, reminds me of an impressionist painting. And the interesting thing about a theme in variations is how many different emotions, how much they can get out of the same theme. So I'm curious to see what we're all going to hear now.
Okay, we have a lovely little woodwind sextet for you by Theodore Blumer. And he was a pianist, a teacher, conductor, composer. He wrote some operas. His music is known for its lush, late romantic harmonies. And he wrote this quintet with piano in 1921. And this has a theme, a melody, a song, and it's followed by seven variations based on that theme. So you'll hear some of the similar melodies with different harmonies, different rhythms, different melodic shapes. So each variation features a particular instrument, and you can listen to how the original melody is transformed in each variation. You'll hear a romantic piano, you'll hear the playful flute, warm oboe, exciting clarinet, romantic French horn, and duet, and a cheerful bassoon, all culminating in a rousing finale where we're all together. So enjoy. Thanks for coming.
Thank you. world.